In recent times, cloud computing has seen an ascendance like never before. Since Microsoft Azure is a leading cloud service provider, getting Microsoft Azure certified would definitely give your career a much needed boost. I am Vishal from Edureka and I welcome you all to this session where I'm going to give you an overview of one such certification. Yes, I'm referring to Microsoft Azure 7532 certification in particular. As we move further, in future sessions, I would be talking about other certifications as well. But that is a discussion for some other time. As far as this session goes, I would be talking about Microsoft Azure 7532 certification only. So let's not waste any time and quickly take a look at today's agenda first. So first and foremost, I would be talking about what the exam exactly covers. I would also talk about who should go ahead and take this exam. I would discuss the exam basics and exam topics. You would also see what are the different types of questions that you should expect in this exam and what approach should one take to tackle these questions. Finally, I would talk about the overall difficulty level as far as this exam goes. I hope this agenda is clear to all of you. So let's move further and take a look at the first topic of discussion. So what does this exam exactly cover? Well, we all know that this examination is for Microsoft Azure Cloud Platform. Now, this is a hybrid cloud platform and you are expected to go ahead and build applications as far as this platform is concerned. So you would be tested from a developer's perspective as to how do you approach various problems that you come across as far as your business is concerned, and how do you build solutions and tackle all the problems that are there while you are approaching these questions. As we move further, we would be discussing this topic a little more so you would have a lot more clearer picture as to what I'm saying exactly. So who should take the exam? Well, this exam is for quite a few people actually, for people who have different approaches and who like different things. Let's try to take a look at what are the eligibilities or who are the people who should actually take the exam. Firstly, you should be good at building solutions. Now, since we are talking about Azure platform, as I've already mentioned, this exam is for people who would actually go ahead and build solutions. As the name itself suggests, you are expected to build solutions for Azure platform. So you should be good at designing these solutions. Now, when I say these solutions, that means you should be able to work throughout the life cycle of a particular problem or a business solution. You should be able to implement these solutions on Azure platform, and you should also be able to program for this platform. Now, we know that we are talking about cloud platforms. So with cloud platforms comes automation and monitoring. If you are interested in these kinds of roles, then again, you should be good at monitoring and automating various solutions. Now, there are quite a few other points which you need to consider. Normally, when you're talking about this platform, you would be hired based on the experience that you have. People normally do not hire freshers who are completely new to these technologies or terms. Yes, you might have experience for cloud in different programming languages or for different tools. That is completely fine. But you should know the basic know-how as to how does one go ahead and approach a particular problem and build the solution as far as your particular business problem is concerned. That experience does hold in very nicely. Now, say for example, I'm giving you a particular problem statement. So you should have worked in certain atmosphere to know what am I trying to put forth or how should you actually go ahead and approach this problem. So that comes with experience. So that is why I'm saying that you normally, people do not hire people who are fresher. So you need to have either some experience or you should have sufficient hands-on on your own. That is, you might have gone ahead and practiced certain problems, taken projects and all those things. In that case, you would be in a very good state to actually go ahead and appear for this exam. Plus, sufficient amount of study as far as this platform goes would definitely hold you in a very good state. As far as this topic goes, these are some of your interests that are there on the screen. Then you should definitely go ahead and go or take the certification. As far as this topic goes, if you have interest in these domains that are there on the screen, then you should definitely appear for this certification. So let's try to understand the next topic. What are the exam basics? So what is the duration that the exam would test you for? This is not certain. As you can see on the screen, it says approximately 2 hours in total. So this can vary depending upon the number of questions that you have. At times you might be tested for say 100 minutes or maybe even more than 2 hours, say somewhere around 140 minutes. So it is somewhere around 2 hours. So when you do appear for this exam, be prepared that there is no fixed time. There might be a situation where you think that it is for 2 hours and then you approach the exam likewise, but it gets over a little quicker. So you have to be prepared for this. What are the number of questions? Now the time duration is varying. Why? Because you're not certain about the number of questions that would come in the exam. Standard number is 60, but this 60 again varies. You might have 45 questions, 50 questions, or a little more than 60 as well. So that depends totally upon the moderator, as in what kind of exam are they setting it for you. And these patterns, they vary quite frequently because Microsoft Azure likes to keep it spicy and changing. So that is what they do. Vary the exam patterns every now and then. So you might expect different questions and different timelines for your exam. What are the languages in which you can appear for this exam? English, a standard language. You can appear for it in Spanish, Chinese, French, German, Russian, Japanese, etc. Scoring. Now, this is another area of confusion. Microsoft Azure expects you to score 700 points to clear this exam. Again, 700 points is not 70%. Say, for example, you have 50 questions in the exam. That does not mean that if you score 35 questions or do them correctly, then you clear the exam. Again, the way Microsoft Azure points or grades you is totally different. At times, certain questions might have 1 point. Certain questions might have more than 1 point, depending upon the complexity which the Microsoft Azure platform feels the question should grade it for. Accordingly, or based on that, they would grade you. The exam fees. Now, to understand this better, you should actually visit their website. Since you would be appearing for this exam from different locations, based on your location and the currency that is supported, you would be charged accordingly. Now, as we move towards the demo part, which I would be giving you to some extent, when I say demo, I would be walking you through the exam details. And while we do that, we can take a look at the different exam prices, as in what different regions have different prices. Meanwhile, you bear with me and we can move further and take a look at the next topic of discussion. Okay, so let us move further and try to understand the next topic, that is, what are the different exam topics which you can expect as far as this certification goes? Create and manage virtual machines. Now, since we are talking about cloud platform, you're dealing with a lot of virtualizations. Why? Because we are talking about customization and constant integration. You would be dealing with different tools, different technologies. So your system or your application should be flexible enough to accommodate these changes and integrate with these different technologies as well. And what is the best approach to do that? Have a virtual machine. Design and implement data and storage strategy. We are talking about scalability because cloud platforms are highly scalable. And to meet the different needs of maybe your website or application, you might be required to change your storage capabilities or capacities and all those things. So you should have the basic know-how, not just the basic, a detailed know-how as to how data is stored, how it works, how do you manipulate it, and all those things. You should be able to manage, identify applications and network services. We are talking about monitoring here. That means you'd be having a number of applications that are running, and these applications will have varying amounts of data, traffic, and all those things. So you should be able to keep track of all the metrics that are there. And you also need to have quite a good understanding of how networks work, as in how do you approach different services that are there in the network? How do you communicate with different services? And how do you approach different problems that you come across? So you need to have overall management knowledge and networking knowledge as well. Finally, you should be able to design and implement Azure web and mobile services as well, because Azure supports different kinds of web applications and mobile services as well. Now, as we move into the demo part, I would be discussing these domains in detail as well. So what are the different types of questions that you should expect in this exam? Well, you need to understand this point that more than 50% of the questions are scenario based. That means you'd be having more than 2 to 3 scenarios. And in these scenarios, you'd be having 4 to 5 questions or somewhere in that range. So you'd have to go through that scenario, understand it, and then appear for the questions that are there. Then you have something called as standalone questions, which are topic specific and which do not have any dependencies on other questions. You'd have one question and you'd have a straightforward answer for that question. And you also have coding questions. Now, this wasn't the case always, but yeah, recent reviews or what people have told me with their experiences, they've also experienced questions which have coding. That means you'd be given a particular snippet or a particular problem statement, and you'd be expected to code in different programming languages as well. When I say different programming languages, you're talking about the programming languages that are supported by our .NET framework. So yeah, these are the types of questions which you can expect in the exam. Let us now try to understand how should you go ahead and tackle these problems. First, let's try to understand scenario-based questions. First thing you need to understand is these scenarios are lengthy. So you would not want to spend too much time just trying to understand the scenario. First thing you need to do is you need to skim through it. That means try to understand as much as you can and then go ahead and read the questions, as in what is expected out of the question. There would be quite a few distractions. If you have, say, maybe what, some 20 lines question or scenario, most of it would lead you to a part where you would not want to go. That means there would be quite a few distractions. So be aware of these distractions as well and try to keep a straightforward approach where you can actually go ahead and understand the questions. Next, there would be quite a few distractions. Now you have a scenario which has, say, 20 to 25 lines. In that, you'd be having certain lines which are just meant to misguide you or take you to a path where you don't want to. So be aware of that thing and stay focused and try to understand what are certain points which you need to concentrate on. And accordingly, you should go ahead and appear for the questions that are there. keep your answers specific and try to find out an answer which is specific to the point, because even the answers that are there, they would try to confuse you a little. And if you get stuck in the distractions, accordingly, what will happen is you would be led to an answer which you would not want to select. So be specific and try to understand these questions much better. You can actually go back and forth in these scenarios, but once you go ahead and save or make changes to a particular scenario and then save it, then you cannot go back and actually make changes to it. So be aware that when you submit the answers, before that, you verify your answers and then submit it. So how do you approach standalone questions? Well, it is easier compared to scenario-based questions. Why? It is a single statement or a couple of statements combined together, and it leads to a particular answer. So you have to understand the statement or statements, and accordingly, you need to go ahead and select the answers that you want to write. All you need to understand is you should be good enough with managing the time. Why? Because you are not certain how many questions would be asked, and you need to be fast yet accurate while appearing or attempting these questions. You need to have a clear perspective, and you should try to understand what the moderator is trying to ask when he's putting that question for you. So yes, you also need to understand it from a different person's perspective, as in when a person is asking you a question, what is he exactly expecting? What kind of business problem you need to approach, and how do you need to approach it? Make sure you attempt all the questions. Why? Because there is no negative marking. And since we are talking about standalone questions, you mostly would be having options which you need to select. So you just need to go ahead and select the options. So do not think about it in different perspective and leave certain questions. Just try to make sure you attempt all the questions and you would be good enough to go. Manage your time well, because time is something which you're not certain about. It might vary. And if you give less or proper time to attempting standalone questions, you'd have more time to focus on the scenario-based questions as well. Overall difficulty. Before I get here, let me talk about the coding part as well. Now, as I've already mentioned, in recent times, there have been questions that deal with coding as well. Now, this exam is from a developer's perspective. That means, yes, you can expect programming questions and questions from various programming languages as well. That means you won't be tested only on particular programming language. You might be tested for different programming languages as well. So make sure that you're thorough enough with your programming skills and all those things as well, because programming can be tough. And as far as the review goes, these exams are very difficult when you talk about the programming part, or at least those are at a moderate level. And you should not be mistaken by thinking that, okay, it might be some easier programming approach which I can take and just clear the exam. People actually practice a lot for these exams, and the questions can be quite challenging because Microsoft likes keeping you on your feet. So what is the overall difficulty when you talk about this exam? If you are a developer, then this exam would be easy for you. But if you're someone who does not know programming, let me tell you, you need to have sufficient hands-on before you do appear for this exam, because as I've already mentioned, programming is something that you'd be tested on constantly. Quite a few coding problems. Yes, we've discussed this already. And about 50% questions would be scenario-based, which can be very time-consuming. These are some of the programming languages that you can expect. As I've already mentioned, it is something that is Microsoft Azure is something that tests you on .NET framework as well. Now, when you talk about .NET framework, you're talking about programming languages like C#, Visual Basic, and all those things. So you should be someone who's good with dealing with these programming languages, at least, that is C#, C#, Node.js, Java, etc. And you should know the basic data structures or the programming fundamentals at least, because you might come across snippets where you'd be expected to go ahead and write solutions. Now, it may not always test you on a particular programming language, but it would test you on your programming approach or how good you are when you actually have to go ahead and make decisions or write codes accordingly. So make sure that your logical ability is much clearer and you know how to go ahead and approach for a particular programming language as well. So when you talk about overall difficulty level, you need to understand this point. That is, this exam might be easier for few people who have sufficient experience on all these things. For people who are completely new to all these terminologies, they actually need to go ahead and practice a lot. So make sure that you are prepared well enough, and then you go ahead and appear for this exam. Let me just quickly switch to the Azure website and let's try to understand what are the certain nitty-gritties that we might have just missed about. Okay, so what I've done is I've actually gone ahead and opened the website, that is the page where you have all the information for this particular exam. As you can see, it's exam 7532, and this is official page by Microsoft Azure. So you can actually come here and check in all the details. This is the link. As far as this page goes, I believe we have discussed most of the points that are here. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to quickly walk through all the points so that we can cover the points which we might have missed on. Firstly, if you take a look at the languages, you can see that Chinese gives you both options, that is simplified and traditional. I actually do not know the difference, but for people who are Chinese or who want to give it in maybe Chinese would know the difference in a better manner. So you're free to actually choose that as well. Plus it is available in other languages as well, like Portuguese, Brazil, Russian as well, and all those things. When you talk about the exam fees, now depending upon the location where you are appearing the exam from, the price might vary. If you are in Portugal, you would be paying somewhere around 165 euros. If you are from some other place, you click here and select your place from this tab, or the drop-down rather. Say you are from maybe South Africa. So click here and the fees would be somewhere around 55 USD, that is US dollars. If you are from India, you'd be paying somewhere around 4,800 INR, that is Indian rupees. So the fees varies from location to location. Feel free to come here and explore that as well. You can click on this link or this tab and it would take you to the place where you can actually schedule your exam. But I won't be doing that. When you scroll down, you'd understand the skills or what is expected out of you, the general guidelines or description that is expected out of you. Plus you have the exam details. Now we've talked about these points, but here you can see that there is the percentage for which the particular domain is there in the exam. That is, this particular domain would have somewhere around 20 to 25% weightage. If you click here, you have the detailed explanation as in what are the topics that are expected from you. And you have a detailed description as in this is a particular topic and this is what you're expected to do. So you should definitely come here and visit this website as well. And it is same for almost every domain or every segment that the exam tests you on. Now, when you scroll further down, you have all the preparation options. That is your online training, instructor-led training, exam prep videos, your practice tests. What does the community has to offer to you? Do visit this because this is very helpful. You'll have all the questions and dumps that are required. Not dumps exactly, but quite a few resources to refer and some live problems, which would definitely help you be in a much better state to crack this exam. There are books which are very useful as well. Now, this is the website and I wanted to come here and visit this because there is a lot to extract out of this website and you'd be in a merry or a very happy position once you do visit this website. Now, if you're somebody who is looking for more structured approach towards training or learning these topics now, then I might suggest this website, that is Edureka. What they do is they provide you online certification training and it is quite a reputed institute. What you can do is you can actually come here and you can do appear for this certification training or take a look at this page as well, because it gives you a detailed information as in how do they approach towards a particular certification training. Now they have weekend batches where you have classes for say 3 hours and it's a 6-week course basically. Apart from that, you have quite a few other things as in you have a detailed course curriculum. Now this course curriculum in particular focuses on this exam, that is 7532, which we are talking about right now. And there are quite a few other features as well, as in they have projects and those projects get evaluated. You have various real life case studies, instructor-led sessions, assignments, and lifetime access to the LMS. Now that is their learning management system where you have all the resources and the lectures that you've attended and you can review those lectures again and again. Even if a particular course is out, as in if Edureka does not take that course anymore, you still have access to this LMS and it would be there in your system where you can access all the resources that are there. Even if that course is scrapped by Edureka, you'd still have access to that. Plus you have something called as 24/7 expert support. There are teams which actually revert back to all your questions and do give you solutions if there are questions which need attending. Plus you have a proper certification. Edureka also gives you a certification of confirmation that you've successfully cleared their exam and you've actually gone ahead and worked on all the course material and inputs which you are supposed to give in. So yes, after the certification exam which Edureka conducts, if you clear that, you would be given a certification as well. And once you do go through all this training, you actually would be in a much better state to go ahead and crack the certification exam, that is exam 7532. So this was about the Azure 7532 certification. And I hope that I've covered all the nitty-gritties as far as this certification goes. If you do have any other queries, feel free to put those queries in the comment section below and I would be more than happy to answer those queries as well. But as far as this session goes, I would be resting my session for now. Thank you. Bye-bye.
I hope you have enjoyed listening to this video. Please be kind enough to like it and you can comment any of your doubts and queries and we will reply them at the earliest. Do look out for more videos in our playlist and subscribe to Edureka channel to learn more. Happy learning!